Hello students, my name is Uttam Khot, working as an assistant professor in Department of Basic Science and Humanities, SITCV, Yadra. And today we are going to start with unit number 4 from Engineering Chemistry, that is Fuels and Lubricant. This is the syllabus content of our topic Fuels and Lubricant, which we are going to cover in coming lectures. This is the course outcome of Engineering Chemistry. Regarding with this topic, at the end of the course, students will able to illustrate and test for different properties of fuels and lubricants. For today's lecture, we are going to cover these are the points from first section, that is fuel. These two points are very much important. So let us start with first section of topic, that is fuel. Fuel contains some major contents like carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, sulfur, nitrogen, etc. Likewise, fuel also contains some minor contents like moisture content, volatile matter, ash content, shale, kaolin, chloride, sulfides, etc. The major contents in the fuel are get combined with the oxygen during the combustion process. Formation of some combustion products and large amount of heat energy is get liberated, and the heat energy liberated can be get used economically for domestic and industrial purposes. We can take the example of fuel as a coke. Coke contains large amount of carbon. Carbon in the coke is get combined with the oxygen from the atmosphere. Formation of CO2 gas plus heat energy is get liberated. So how we can define the fuels? The fuel can be called as the chemical fuel. We can define likewise, chemical fuel is a combustible carbonaceous material which on proper burning in the presence of air, which gives large amount of heat energy that can be get used economically for domestic and industrial purposes. In other way, we can define the fuel. It is a combustible substance which during combustion gives large amount of heat energy, nothing but the fuel. We are using various types of fuels in day-to-day life like wood, charcoal, coal, kerosene, petrol, diesel. Producer gas is the combination of carbon monoxide gas and nitrogen gas. Water gas is the combination of carbon monoxide gas and hydrogen gas, natural gas, etc. These are the examples of, we can say, fuels which we are using in day-to-day life. So how we can define the fuels? Chemical fuel is the substance which on burning which gives large amount of heat energy that can be get used economically for domestic and industrial purposes. That is nothing but the fuel. So next point is the classification of fuels. The fuels can be get classified on the basis of two ways, on the basis of occurrence and on the basis of physical state. On the basis of occurrence, that means from which source we are getting the fuel. Either it is from natural sources or from artificial sources, nothing but the on the basis of occurrence. And second way is the on the basis of physical state. In which state we are getting the fuel actually, either it is in the solid state or in the liquid state or in the gaseous state, nothing but the on the basis of physical state. So first of all, on the basis of occurrence, nothing but the, we can say we can have two types: primary fuels and secondary fuels, or also called as primary fuels can be called as natural fuels, and secondary fuels can be called as artificial fuels. Primary fuels are those which are available in the nature as it is. Examples, we can take coal, crude petroleum, natural gas are the examples of primary fuels which are available in the nature as it is. These fuels are get formed within the earth by the decomposition of continuous decomposition of organic matter by the action of heat, by the action of pressure, by the action of temperature, which take million years within the earth. Because of that, we can refer as a fossil fuel. Example, coal, crude petroleum, natural gas, nothing but the primary, or we can say natural fuels. Secondary fuels are those which are derived from naturally occurring ones which by some chemical treatment. Means that secondary fuels are get formed by primary fuels on chemical treatments. We can take the example as a coke, gasoline, coal gas, producer gas, water gas, kerosene, etc. On the basis of physical state, we can have three categories, solid fuels, liquid fuels and gaseous fuels. We can see the classification of fuels in compiled way like this. Fuel can be classified on the basis of occurrence as natural fuels and secondary, we can say artificial fuels. Natural fuels can be called as primary fuels and artificial fuels can be called as a secondary fuels. Again, both the fuels, primary and secondary fuels, are get classified in three categories on the basis of physical state as a solid fuels, liquid fuel and gaseous fuel. We can take the example as a solid primary fuels as a wood. Peat is the type of coal actually. We can take here coal, wood is the example of solid primary fuels. Crude petroleum, oil, crude oil is the example of liquid primary fuels. Natural gas is the example of gaseous primary fuels. For the examples of secondary fuels, coke, charcoal is the example of solid secondary fuels. Petrol, diesel, kerosene, which are obtained from these crude petroleum oil by some chemical treatments, nothing but the liquid secondary fuels. Coal gas, water gas, LPG, biogas is an example of, we can say, gaseous secondary fuel. So this is our classification. The next point is very much important, that is nothing but the calorific value of the fuel. This calorific value of fuel decides the fuel quality, or we can say quality of fuel, that can be defined as, it is the total amount of heat liberated by complete combustion of unit mass or unit volume of fuel sample is nothing but the calorific value of the fuel sample. The calorific value of fuel sample is can be called as the heating value of the fuel sample. That is very much important during the selection of any kind of fuel. And that calorific value of the fuel sample can be get expressed in terms of these are the units. For solid fuels, we can use calorie per gram or kilocalorie per kilogram unit. And for liquid and gaseous fuels, we can use calorie per cm cube or kilocalorie per meter cube. So how we can define the calorific value? It is the total amount of heat liberated by complete combustion of unit mass or unit volume of the fuel sample. It is nothing but the calorific value of the fuel sample or heating value of the fuel sample. There is even another term regarding with this value, nothing but the calorie, that can be get used for conversion purposes. Okay, it can be defined as, it is the total amount of heat required to raise the temperature of 1 gram of water by 1 degree Celsius. It is the total amount of heat required to raise the temperature of 1 gram of water by 1 degree Celsius. So we can have conversion here. 1 calorie is equal to 4.184 joules. If you want to convert the calorie heat energy into joules, we have to multiply the answer with the 4.184. we can get the value in the joules. Next point is, the we are having types of the calorific value. There are two types of calorific value. First is the gross calorific value. Gross calorific value, that can be called as the higher calorific value, or we can say SCV or GCV. A second type is the net calorific value. It can be called as a lower calorific value. We can say LCV or NCV. So how we can define that one? First of all, we can revise the calorific value. Total amount of heat produced by complete combustion of unit mass or unit volume of given fuel sample is known as a calorific value of the fuel sample. We are having two types, calorific value, HCV and LCV, or we can call GCV or NCV. So how we can define this one? The total amount of heat produced by complete combustion of unit mass or unit volume of fuel sample in the presence of air or in the presence of oxygen, and allow the process of combustion to cool down to the room temperature, is known as a higher or gross calorific value. Okay, in other way, we can say the HCV is summation of two heat energies actually, means that the total amount of heat liberated by burning of fuel sample and the heat liberated by cooling of combustion products, nothing but the SCV or GCV. In case of next type, that is the net or lower color value, nothing but the LCV or SCV, we can define total amount of heat produced by complete combustion of unit mass or unit volume of fuel sample and allow the gaseous products to escape, is known as a net or lower color value. Means that the LCV or NCV is the only heat energy liberated by complete combustion of unit mass or unit volume of fuel sample.